traveling to Albuquerque, New Mexico, and we are close to Las Cruces, I believe, and this is the rest area. I wanted to show some hip and shoulder stretches. So you could use the mat if you have it, no mat is needed. I just like to be on my mat. I have the good Manduka mat, which is thicker, so I don't even, on this gravel, I don't feel it actually. It nicely massages my feet a little bit. So we call that humble warrior in yoga. So you're gonna step one leg back and clasp your hands behind your sacrum bone. If you cannot clasp, use some towel or some piece of clothing or a belt. Squeeze your upper arms or the towel, lift the heart, and then fold forward. Really good stretch for your neck and for the shoulders. You could hover here and drop your head down, or you could go all the way inside of your thigh. And you could release your hands down and actually you could do a little deeper lunge if you want to. If you have the back leg up for that stretch, keep your knee above your heel. Sure that if you drop your knee down, kind of don't worry about this knee, you can go a little bit forward, a little bit to the side for a little bit deeper outer hip stretch. You could stay with your straight arms. You could, if you have that range, you could drop your forearms down. And the same thing with another side. So you could forward, do a little forward fold here, and step back with your other leg and then clasp your hands, squeeze your arms, fold forward, hover here, or go a little deeper. And the same here, either leg up, knee down, arms up, or forearms down. So this is a really nice hip and shoulder stretch. Another exercise that is really good for your shoulders and your hips, it's called the goddess pose in yoga, or sometimes the horse stance. So you bend your knees and make sure you have your toes facing the same direction as your knees, and kind of you could wiggle, wiggle, wiggle your feet a little bit wider. Have your hands above your knees, just on your thighs. And then you will begin to twist to one side, so opposite shoulder to the opposite knee, and sink a little bit deeper as you do that. Really good side stretch, and then really good the shoulder stretch, and sinking a little bit deeper. And now one, you could kind of shorten your stance and do squat. The squats are always good, like lengthening. Really, the squats are really good poses to lengthen your back, especially your low back, and really good release to the neck. And you could do a little forward fold, a little bit of dangling. You could bend your knees actually.